Daphne Bridgerton, presented by her mother, the Right Honourable the Dowager Viscountess Bridgerton.
Despite an introduction, madam, I do believe accosting me to be the least civilized of ways.
Accosting you?
Stare into my eyes. Here. Closer. If this is to work, you must appear madly in love.
It is an absurd plan.
I find it quite brilliant. Provided you do not wish to marry me, and I do not wish to marry you, whatever should he have to lose?
You need not feel your evident worry. Burbrook is...
You've not heard what Whistledown writes of me still. No, even if you believe Lord Burbrook is taken care of, our ruse is not finished. I'm still in need of a husband.
No, I am flattered. I'm afraid I must reject your proposal.
Yes, I know. You're not the marrying type. Yet have you considered you are not the type women wish to marry?
I do suppose if I were forced to take a wife, you would be the least objectionable option.
Is that meant to be a compliment?
Yes, but it is no matter, for you wish to marry for love, do you not?
Of course I do. They're still looking.
I cannot tell you.
I thought we were friends.
Daphne.
Simon. Tell me. Tell me.
All right. What happens between a husband and a wife? Well, it is a natural continuation of what happens at night.
At night? What happens at night?
When you are alone.
When I am sleeping.
Not when you are sleeping. When you touch yourself, you do touch yourself.
Enjoy.
right. You can carry on with that until the feeling grows. And then eventually you reach the pinnacle, a release. And that should help you. I cannot provide it for you. Nor could I ever ask such a sacrifice. Please, Daphne, for your own sake, you must stand aside and let your brother finish this.
It was love at first sight.
It was not, Your Majesty. The young lady flatters me. It was not love at first sight for either of us. There's attraction, certainly, at least on my part. But Miss Bridgerton thought me presumptuous, arrogant, insincere, all fair, really. And I thought her a prim young lady barely out of leading strings, not to mention the sister of my best friend, and so romance was entirely out of the question for both of us. But in so removing it, we found something far greater. We found friendship. You see, Miss Bridgerton and I have been fooling all of Mayfair for quite some time. We've fooled them into thinking we are courting. And really, all along, we simply enjoyed each other's company so much we could not stay away from one another. I've never been a man that much enjoyed flirting, or chatting, or indeed talking at all. But with Daphne, Miss Bridgerton, conversation has always been easy. Her laughter brings me joy. To meet a beautiful woman is one thing, but to meet your best friend and the most beautiful of women is something entirely apart. And it is with my sincerest apologies, I must say, it took the prince coming along for me to realize I did not want Miss Bridgerton to only be my friend, I wanted her to be my wife.
You burn for me.
Why do you think I followed you into that garden?
Why do you think I went into that garden? If you would have only looked at me this week for longer than 2 seconds, you would have seen. It is you I cannot sacrifice. I burn for you.
So sorry.
For what? Even a duke cannot control the weather.
I know that this is not what you had envisioned for the evening.
Certainly not.
For that, I...
It is better. I know why you made that vow to your father. I found the letters you wrote to him as a child, and I read them.
Yes, he...
Just because something is not perfect does not make it any less worthy of love. Your father made you believe otherwise. Every flaw, every imperfection. I love you. You may think you are too damaged and too broken to ever allow yourself to be happy, but you can choose differently, Simon. You can choose to love me as much as I love you. That should not be up to anyone else. That cannot be up to anyone else. It can only be up to you.
Thank you.